Now I introduce Ciara Lewis, who's giving her account of her experiences.
Wow, I did not expect this many people to be here. Oh my God, this is not something I'm used to. But I was 12 years old when I was sexually assaulted. It was my friend's big brother, who I'll refer to as A. In the place I was staying, I should have been safe. It's Guernsey, right? After 2 long weeks of trying to hide and deny what happened, I was lucky enough to have a close family member who I trusted, alongside incriminating messages from him to me via social media. Together we reported it. He was arrested and I was taken for a video interview. At the ripe age of 12, a shy, embarrassed little girl, I could not say the word penis. He made a full admission in interview, and the case wouldn't have gone before the court if it was not for what he had told officers. Marked under unusual circumstances, the case was closed and A received a 3-year probation order. A few months later, he breached the court order by failing to notify his new address, and A was presented a 15-month custodial sentence. Why wasn't the initial offence enough reason for a custodial sentence, but failing to change your address was? This was just the first time I was let down by the criminal justice system in Guernsey. Shortly after, I left the island. You're not exactly the hot topic of the school for any of the right reasons when you're let down by the court on a case like this. I was called a liar, an attention seeker. I lost so many friends through not being believed. Blackpool is in the top 10 roughest places to live in the UK. I was never sexually assaulted in the 5 years I lived in Blackpool. In 2019, in April, I returned to Guernsey to join my family. After finishing my education, I was 17, I'd healed from my past trauma. I was rebirthed, reblossomed as a young woman now compared to the little girl I was when I left. It will never happen to me again. At least the trauma is over with now. At least it's taught me lessons. October 2019, I was just about to turn 18, out drinking with my two friends. I didn't know them that well. By the end of the night, what resulted into what CCTV footage proved, I was in no fit state to consent. I have split-second memory of that night, the last thing being in a taxi with my friends and feeling very squashed and claustrophobic. From police statements, it was proved that I was passed out when I was left there. I woke up completely naked in a place I'd never been, in a bed next to a man I never knew, and I had no recollection of the past 10 hours. I was naked. I never get naked for anyone. I asked who I refer to as B if we had had sex. He said no. He revealed a huge scratch mark down his chest. You were too out of it. I left the building feeling pain in areas I'd never experienced before. A woman knows when something isn't right. Again, with anger, complete confusion, yet a little bit of trust, I reported the same day. Presenting DNA samples and a video statement, I was told I had a really strong case here. He was DNA tested as well. Before the forensically linked positive DNA results came back, he'd already fled the island after 8 years back to Latvia. Officers closed the case, seeking it too expensive to continue investigating without him on island, and that they would reinvestigate if he returned. So, reflecting on my experience, I've encountered a number of mental health illnesses. I ended up in a confusing lesbian relationship for 4 years, even though I knew I wasn't interested in girls. I couldn't trust men, with an absent father also. I was trying to find love from somewhere. Shortly after the second assault, I ended up in trouble with the police, leaving me homeless and jobless. Luckily, I've managed to pull myself together now, today, through faith and forgiveness, which are subjects that I don't have time to touch on today. But if you are struggling, I urge you, go and research. But what has it changed? I see A's face everywhere now, in the streets with his girlfriend and his child, on a night out, which I avoid at all costs. I'll be reluctant to raise a child in Guernsey unless things change around us. I have flashbacks and nightmares. I don't go to certain places. I don't walk alone at night. Some justice needs to be served for our future generation. I would love to see everyone pushing for harsher investigations into rape and sexual assault accusations, a more advanced victim support scheme, passport seized upon investigation, sentencing increase. Why are we educating the youth of our generation that you'll only be lightly punished, if at all, for these crimes that steal lives? I'd like to end on breaking stigmas. Imagine a world where we didn't feel like an outcast for speaking up about our stories, or called a liar or an attention seeker. Imagine a place where we were taught a little more rights from wrong at school over a lot of algebra. Imagine walking down the street at night without turning your shoulder, panicking every 2 seconds. Could you just imagine if we could denormalise seeing someone completely out of it in town and walking past like it's not a problem? Reach out, make sure that person is safe, or help them to a safe place, because you could change their life. And not all men, but 97%. Meaning most, if not all, of the women in your life have been sexually harassed or assaulted. Have a really good think about it. It will unfold. Every single woman I know has their own story to tell. 97%. Thank you.